the field accomplishments that we've made with the noxious weeds. There's never been this many boots on the ground in Shoshone County chasing weeds before.
What we do is it's a stimulus funded project that we are going to fight the noxious weeds that are on the Idaho state noxious weed list. But it's from the federal government through the Forest Service, is through the ISDA, and then out to the counties, different counties. It's through the Silver Valley mainly, but we also go over to the St. Joe River to Calder, between Calder and Avery. We also journey down, which is a little further down, to Clarkia, which is the bottom half of the county. And we try to, right now, go for four different types of weeds. All of the knotweed varieties, blueweed or viper's blood gloss, hound's tongue, and Scotch broom. We spray, we dig, we pull, whatever we can do to get rid of that weed. The weeds that we're going after mostly are imports from other countries. They are not natural, therefore they do not have a biocontrol that's naturally to their area that they live in. Problem is, once they get away, there's no enemies, and so they proliferate. These types of weeds push out the native species, and therefore there's nothing more for these native wildlife to eat, or even the cows. Okay, so the area that they can live in gets smaller and smaller and smaller. Also, ladder fuels, especially things like knotweed, is going to go up, and it's tall. It can cause a treetop fire as opposed to a lower brush fire. So a couple of reasons for that.
We are in a county that our private foresters tell us that there's 2 to 3 times the foliage load on the forest floor than there was in the 1910 event.
Because we know that weeds continually grow back, and we would like to, as the funds come down, be able to sustain the effort.
We go around and spray noxious weeds. It's important because a lot of these plants don't have any natural enemies, so they choke out other plants and they're toxic to animals around here, and also they can build up and become ladder fuels and start fires.
Part of the project, we also helped in our local county fire mitigation team do some work in the hillsides like this to reduce the fuels that can cause a fire. We come in behind it as the county noxious weed crew and spray for any vegetation that we don't want around, any noxious weeds, and then later on we come back and reseed the area to get some native grasses growing in that will overshadow any weeds or possible weed infestations that can occur after such a project as this.
We're a county that is high unemployment. We're constantly trying to, we are a natural resource-based economy here.
We've got 9 people in the noxious weeds, and right now 9 people in fire mitigation. So yeah, it's provided some jobs and been very beneficial.
From the standpoint of the economy and people that needed work, because it's a hands-on job, and this county's in, traditionally been in that unemployment for many, many years. So it was very helpful to the economics of Shoshone County too.
You know, it's gonna look good on a resume, having, being a professional applicator and being able to read all the labels and all of that.
It's helping me save up for school and do that, and living expenses and everything, definitely.
We go around and spray all the noxious weeds around the county, pull Scotch broom. It helps out the community so it doesn't get impacted with all the weeds, and just kind of makes it look better.
That's been a big benefit. They're now experts. They're out there every day doing the job. I think that some of the things they've learned from this job, they'll be able to carry on and probably get some good employment opportunities from it.